sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Hyperborea. The notion of Atlantis was further confused by some ancient Greek legends concerning another semi-mythical land, Hyperborea. Amongst the Greeks, there dwelt a number of foreigners, who allegedly had come from somewhere in the northwest. The Greeks referred to them as Hyperboreans, from the word Boreas, meaning the north wind, and claimed that they came from a country far beyond the Pillars of Hercules. Pliny makes reference to them as coming from the north. It was said that the sun always shone in that country, which was a peninsula from a much larger frozen continent, and that Apollo often wintered amongst these people. It is thought that the Hyperboreans who dwelt amongst the Greeks were either slaves or captured mercenary warriors, and that their country might have been a geographical mixture of Britain and the Scandinavian lands. The idea of Hyperborea was to appeal, not so much to H.P. Lovecraft, although he did make mention of it, but to one of his contemporaries, Robert E. Howard, creator of Conan the Barbarian. The Hyperborean lands, home of a tall fair-haired people, bordered on Conan's own native land of Sumeria, and the Hyborian Age in which many of his adventures are set, holds overtones of an ancient land. During World War II, the Nazi Party were deeply interested in Hyperborea as the possible home of the Aryan race from which Hitler claimed that all true Germans were descended. It was the home, the Nazis decided, of ancient occult mysteries and powers, and therefore was located by German occultists as being somewhere near the North Pole, perhaps within a Sim's hole. Hitler believed that this ancient land had been inhabited by a race of fair-haired giants who were physically perfect in every way, and this became the prototype for his ideal of the master race.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.